Welcome back. In the last video, few numericals from bandit theory we have tried to solve them. In this video, some more numericals we will solve. So take the next numerical. A sample of intrinsic semiconductor has carrier concentration. Please remember, carrier concentration, it is the charge concentration. 3.2 into 10 raised to 18 per meter cube at room temperature. Now, phosphorus is added. It is doped with phosphorus at a rate of 1 atom per million atoms of semiconductor sample. The concentration of semiconductor atoms 3.6 into 10 raised to 27 per meter cube, and find out the whole concentration band gap is given. Okay. So we have to use here law of mass action. Now it is doped with phosphorus at the rate of 1 atom per million atoms of semiconductor sample. Million means 10 raised to 6. So what does it mean? In 10 raised to 6 atoms of semiconductor, there is one phosphorus atom. That is the meaning of this sentence. Okay, I'll repeat. For 10 raised to 6 atoms of semiconductor material, there is one phosphorus atom. Now, how many semiconductor atoms are there? That concentration is given 3.6 into 10 raised to 27. So, how many phosphorus atoms would be there? For 10 raised to 6, it is 1. So, for 3.6 into 10 raised to 27, how many atoms will be there? Yes, we use the simple formula. It is ND, D for donor. So, donor density is 3.6 into 10 raised to 27 upon 10 raised to 6. So, we get 3.6 into 10 raised to 21. Now, we know one donor atom gives one electron. So, donor density, we can say it is the electron density or electron concentration NN, because it is N-type semiconductor, so we take suffix N. NN is nothing but ND, it is 3.6 into 10 raised to 21. Now, what is the law of mass action? Ni square is equal to NN into PN, that is electron concentration into hole concentration. So, whole concentration is Pn, n for n type. It is ni square upon nl. Now, ni square means intrinsic carrier concentration or intrinsic charge concentration. It is given 3.2 into 10 raised to 18, that is square, upon 3.6 into 10 raised to 21. We get 2.84 into 10 raised to 15 per meter cube. Okay. Just go through all the steps in few seconds. Yes, now we go to next numerical. Yes. Now this is for Hall effect. Magnetic field 1 Tesla is applied to semiconducting sample with donor density 10 raised to 22 per meter cube. Current density 225 ampere per meter square and width 3 millimeter. Find Hall voltage. Now we know the equation for Hall voltage VH is equal to J upon NE BD. See, please remember this equation. And when we use this equation, see, when current density, J means current density. Please remember, again I repeat, in the that video I have cleared you, but again I repeat, J means current density, current per unit area. J upon NEBD, N is given 10 raised to 22 donor density, J current density 225, B is the applied magnetic field, it is 1 Tesla, and D means width of sample 3 millimeter, so 3 into 10 raised to minus 3. N given, E charge of electron, we know that. So you calculate, we get 421.87 into 10 raised to minus 6 volt. So this is the Hall voltage. Okay, just to go through these steps, very simple, only one equation we have to use, J upon NEBD. Now again the similar type of problem, again we take N type semiconductor. Donor density 10 raised to 21 per meter cube means N is given. Magnetic field applied is 4000 gauss. See, remember it is given in gauss. So we have to convert to Tesla. And current is 0.1 milliampere. Remember, it is current, not current density. Find Hall voltage if thickness of the sample is 0.3. Please remember, it is thickness T. If it is width, we take it as D. So don't get confused. Width we denote as D and thickness we denote as T. If you see the figure of Hall effect in the last video, you will find the difference. So we use now this equation, VH equal to IB upon NAD. See, both these equations are before you. See, when current density is given, you use this equation JBD upon NE. We take width. And if current is given, we use this equation IB upon NET. T is the thickness. Got it? See, this equation when current density is given, J, and this equation when current is given. Now just you put all the values, 4000 gauss, it means 0.4, remember, into 10 raised to minus 4, so it will get 0.4. Then all the values are given, so just put it, do the calculation, we get 0.83 millivolt or 0.83 into 10 raised to minus 3 volt. Okay, now next. Yes, copper strip, its dimensions are given, width is 2 cm and thickness is 0.4 mm. It is placed in magnetic field 2.5 Weber per meter square. Now Weber per meter square means Tesla, so it is the SI unit, no conversion required. Current 500 ampere is passed through sample. See, it is the current I. Calculate Hall voltage and assume RH. RH is given, 5.8 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter cube per coulomb. Just think for a while, what equation will you use? Yes, correct, we use this equation, VH is equal to IB upon NET, because I current is given, not J is given. So IB upon NET, T is given 0.4, T is given 0.4, B is given 2.5, and NE, see, it is 1 upon NE means RH, so it is given, N also given, indirectly it is given. Okay, yes, we use this equation, VH is equal to IB upon NET, 1 upon NE means RH, so we get RH IB upon T. Just you put all the values, RH is given, I 500, B 2.5, T 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 3, do the calculation, you will get 1.8 volt. Again, it is the Hall experiment, Hall effect. Current 0.6 ampere is passed through sample, width 5 mm and thickness 0.4 mm. Magnetic field applied 2200 gauss, see, remember it is given in gauss, so it is 0.22. Hall voltage developed is 0.22 millivolt and we have to find carrier concentration and drift velocity. Carrier concentration means we have to find N. Okay, we have to find N. Yes, correct, we use the same formula, VH is equal to IB upon NAT. We use the same formula. Here VH is given, I given, B given, NET, ET given. So we have to find N. So we get N is equal to this formula. You put all the values, 2200 means 0.22. This is 0.22 into 10 raised to minus 3 because it is in millivolt. This is the E and this is T. It is in millimeter. We convert to meter and we get N 9.37 into 10 raised to 24 per meter cube. So one value we get. But our problem is not over here. Again, we have to find drift velocity. So what is the drift velocity? It is the velocity acquired by the charge when electric field applied. Few more steps from the derivation of Hall effect I have given. Actually, we don't need to write this, but just for your understanding, I have repeated. We know Hall voltage is EYD. EY is the Hall field, D is the width. We know in equilibrium, 0 is equal to E EY minus VX BZ. We have this seen this step. So EY is equal to VX BZ. So you put it EY in this equation, we get VH is equal to VX BZD. It means VBD. Because XY just denotes the direction, so not necessary to write. We get VH is equal to VBD. This V is the drift velocity. So drift velocity V is equal to VH upon BD. D is the width. Remember, it is width, not thickness. D. It is given. VH we have calculated. VH is also given. So 0.22 into 10 raised to minus 3. B we know. D we know. And we get 0.2 meter per second. Okay. Go through all the steps. So these are few problems for practice. See, this is the first problem. Probability of exciting electrons to conduction band at 300. Now we know probability of electron is exponential minus Eg upon 2kT. Eg is given. K is 300. So 2kT, we know it is 0.052. So calculate, do the calculation. Fraction of electrons in conduction band. We know fraction of electrons, it means the probability. So we use the same equation here. Same equation, similar type of problem here. Fraction of electrons means the probability. So exponential minus Eg upon 2kT. Again, room temperature is given. So it is 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 47. Because 5.6, it is almost diamond. Compare number of electrons in conduction band, conduction electrons in silicon at temperature 37 and 27. So N2 means 37 and N1 means 27. We have solved, I think, second numerical in the last video is of this type. First we calculate number of electrons at 37. We use the equation 2 into 2 pi m star kT upon h square raised to 3 by 2 exponential minus Eg upon 2kT for temperature 37, for temperature 27, and then do the calculation. Number of electrons near the top of valence band, we know it is capital N, it is given. Intrinsic carrier density, it means number of electrons available for conduction. So it is small n, it is also given, and it is at room temperature. Find the energy gap. So small n upon capital N, we know it is fraction of electrons. This is capital N, this is small n. So n by n is equal to, again we know it is probability, exponential minus Eg upon 2kT. Similar type of problem we have solved in the last video. Germanium has carrier concentration 2.4 into 10 raised to 19 per meter cube at room temperature. It is doped with antimony. 1 atom per million atoms of germanium. Concentration of germanium is given. We know it is law of mass action. So 4 into 10 raised to 28 upon 10 raised to 6. It is donor density. Donor density means electron concentration. And electron concentration into hole concentration is square of intrinsic concentration. This we have solved such type of problem. Magnetic field is applied to semiconducting sample. Width is given. Current density is given. Hall voltage developed is given. And you have to find the conductivity and mobility of electrons is given. Okay. So Hall voltage is given. So VH is equal to JBD upon NE. That formula we have to use for this. So from this formula, we'll get 1 upon NE, that is RH. So mobility RH is equal to mu sigma. This is very simple. Unnecessary magnetic field and current density given. RH is equal to 1 upon NE. Very simple formula we have to use here. Please remember, here we have to use 1 upon NE. So these are some numericals for practice I have given. So, okay, friends, all the best. Thank you.